second. I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom, getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses, asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget. Between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight. We are young, so no, I know that I'm not all that you got. I guess that I just thought maybe we could find new ways to fall apart. But our friends are back, so let's raise a
toast. Well, just a reminder, you've got to have your mask on. Please put your mask on straight away.
Mornings. be seated.
I would like to call upon Mr. Weatherstone, our school's principal, to come up to the stage for the acknowledgement of country and the principal's address.
Thank you, Isaac and Davita. I'd firstly like to acknowledge the Cabrigal clan of the Darug Nation as traditional custodians of the land in which our school and community stands. I'd also like to pay respect to elders both past, present and emerging within our communities. Welcome to our Year 12 graduating class of 2021. To all our staff and most importantly to our parents and community who are watching online, as with COVID restrictions we can't have so many of you here in person. But I know that you are all with us in spirit, and I am pleased that with the recent easing of restrictions, we have been allowed to have one guest for each of our students here today. Last year, I lamented that Year 12 then was a year like no other. And I must admit, I thought when I was saying that last year, that the trials of Year 12 2020 were the worst they could get. But how wrong I could be. There's no doubt that your year, Year 12 of 2021, has had it the toughest of all. And for the sake of those that follow you, I hope that no other Year 12 for the future is faced with the challenges that you've had to face. In 2020, you had 7 weeks of your preliminary course affected by lockdowns and learning from home, and just when we thought this year we were seeing the finish line in sight, right at the end of term two, another lockdown, a heavy-duty lockdown, let's say, that saw you denied face-to-face learning for 12 weeks of your HSC course. It certainly dealt another blow. We thought at first we could just delay your trial HSC exams, but it came clear that with the worsening situation with COVID-19, that you needed certainty and the ability to focus on your learning, and that's a decision that I think was very wise as events played out. The HSC exams were delayed and delayed again, as was the date for this graduation. And the decision to have the graduation now, where we are able to have one guest for each one of you here, has again seemed to have a little bit of wisdom in hindsight, because certainly if our graduation had been held 2 weeks earlier even, that wouldn't have been able to happen. In fact, it wouldn't have been able to happen even up until Friday last week. You've made it through these most difficult circumstances, and while it's been undoubtedly hard, I must tell you that life at times is hard. And you'll find even more challenging times ahead. Hopefully not the same, but indeed more challenging in other different ways. The measure of you is not how you cope when times are good, it's how you cope when times are bad. I'm going to use a very often used cliche, that diamonds are formed under pressure from the most ordinary of materials. So don't let anyone tell you that you are not worthy, and most importantly, don't let yourself tell you that you are unworthy, because your future is here. To be worked on. Success in your careers and your relationships rarely comes easily. It's to be worked at, sometimes hard work, sometimes, hopefully most times, work that brings you joy. And rarely do you reach success alone. It's with the support and guidance of other people that most often happens. So on your behalf, I'd like to thank Ms. Karagiannis and Mr. Campbell, your year advisors, who supported you through your journey through the school. Thank you to Ms. Day and the Year 11 Entertainment class for the organisation of the video feed today, and Kevin Campbell for all of his organisation and running around today and leading up today. To Mrs. Smith and all the ladies in the front office and all my non-teaching staff, they've done an absolutely amazing job to make sure today's happened. And particularly to Mrs. Franks for her work on the presentation and communications out to you, and to Mrs. Owen for the production of your yearbook. And I'd also like to thank your teachers, because they've certainly worked hard to do what they can to prepare you for the HSC, and I know that each one of them wishes you their very best. And my final thanks on your behalf is to your families. I'm sure they are proud of you, and while they would not possibly have wished that you would have had the hardships of the last 2 years, I know they are even prouder of what you've reached to get to this other side. Your student leaders, led by Aisha Ali, your captains Aisha Ali and Sebastian Ribeiro, vice captains Mohammed Syed and Akriti Dutt, and leaders Michaela Brand, Riley Franks, Vina Husha, Jonathan Jabur, Kiana McCarthy, Obeda Mustafa, Prine Muthan, Georgia Pogson, Lachlan Walsh, Messi Yarko, and Amy Zong have continued and strengthened our strong traditions of student leadership within our school. And my final thanks are to you, the Year 12 of 2020, certainly never to be forgotten. You've held yourselves well under very great pressure and enormous change, with situations sometimes changing on a daily basis. But you've got to the end of your secondary schooling, achieved your high school certificate, and are ready to take on the world. You are my last Year 12 group to farewell from this school, as I'll be also saying farewell to the school in 10 days' time, as I look from the other end of the lens of a career and head to retirement. I take a break and leave leadership of this fine school to whoever may replace me, and that decision, I believe, will be made in a week or so's time. The future for each one of you is bright, and I hope that, like that diamond, it is truly dazzling in so many ways. I know, you know, I rarely wish you luck. And the reason for that is because luck is such a fickle thing to rely on. I actually wish each one of you to be better than you could even imagine yourselves to be. I actually wish you to work hard for your success, because that's when success is the sweetest. And you certainly have had to work hard to get here today. And finally, please know that each one of you will remain an important part of our school family, our family of John Edmondson High School. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Weatherstone. Could you please remain on the stage while I call upon Mrs. Violi, the Deputy Principal of John Edmondson High School, to join you to announce our Sports Awards, the Perpetual Awards, and our Double Platinum Award recipients.
Thank you for that. I would like to announce a few awards and again pass on my congratulations to Year 12. You've come through. It's been an absolutely amazing 6 years for you guys, and I'm so proud to be standing here today to congratulate you all on such an amazing achievement. Anyway, I would like to start off by announcing the award recipient for the Rewan Gunnising Award. The Rewan Gunnising Service to School Sport Award is an award that represents great service to school sport over the student's whole John Edmondson High School experience. It is awarded to a Year 12 student or student that has displayed exceptional commitment and dedication to carnivals, knockout sports, gala days, and any other sporting experiences that the school offers. This year, the recipients are Lua Tanyelu and Chanel Burgess. Can you please come up? Congratulations to you both. The New South Wales Premier's Sporting Challenge Medal is awarded to a student who's recognised for their commitment to fair play, achievement in their sporting discipline as a participant, umpire, trainer, assistant, and or sports leader, and overall contribution to the JEHS sporting program. And this year it goes to Alana Mithwood-Lascala. Congratulations, Alana. The Boughton Family Quiet Achievement Award. These are perpetual shields, one for a student in each group who has worked consistently and diligently to achieve commendable results in a quiet, determined fashion without necessarily having topped a particular subject, class or year. These awards were made possible by Sue Galvin, the founding president of the JEHS PNC, and this year the award goes to Yopi Wang. Congratulations, Yopi. The Australian Defence Force Long Tan Leadership and Teamwork Award, named in recognition of the place the Battle of Long Tan holds in the hearts and minds of Australians and the values the veterans displayed on that day. They also act as a fitting tribute to the Long Tan veterans as they encourage and recognise the very values they demonstrate, such as mateship, tenacity, teamwork and leadership amongst our senior students and future leaders. The awards are given to one student in years 10, 11 and 12. Students are selected by the principal for regularly demonstrating values outlined by the award selection criteria within their school and local community. And this year the award goes to Aisha Ali. Congratulations, Aisha. The 2021 Austin Mackle Prize for Ducks of the School. This award is named in honour of Austin Mackle, John Edmondson's platoon leader. Austin Mackle was a man of great intelligence and great achievements. It is a great honour for our school to have his name connected to the prize of ducks of John Edmondson High School. The school community is thankful to his family for allowing us the privilege of doing so. And this year, the Austin Mackle Prize for Ducks goes to Vaibhav Khanna. Congratulations, Vaibhav. And finally, but not without giving absolute commendation to the next lot of awards, these students of the Double Platinum Award have shown outstanding commitment to their studies, to their education, to their whole holistic learning at John Edmondson High School, and have collected over the years many excellence awards that accumulated to their bronze, silver, gold, platinum, and then double platinum. This year we have four recipients, the first one being Aisha Ali. Congratulations, come up onto the stage, please. Dana Batena. Vaibhav Khanna. And Yopi Wang. Congratulations to Aisha, Dana, Vaibhav, and Yopi. And thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Weatherstone and Mrs. Violi. We would now like to begin our 2021 graduation presentation with the awarding of the graduating certificates and merit medallions. Can I please ask Mr. Campbell, the Year 12 Year Advisor, to join us in announcing the graduating class of 2021.
A Hello, everyone. All right, so let's begin with our certificates. First up, we have Yamama Abdulrahman. Okay, next up is Maui Adam. Okay, next up is Hadi Ahmed. Jeanette Ailey. Sultan Al Najam. Okay, we have Hussein Alali. Next up, we have Aisha Ali, who also received a student leadership. There was the bronze, silver, gold, platinum, and double platinum medallions. Okay, and we have Rashil Ali. Okay, next up we have Alana Al-Zuairi. Okay, Chris Ansar, also with a contribution to school sports. Okay, we have Simeon Arnautovic, who also received first in math standard, was house captain of Elliot, and also contribution to school sports. Okay, next up we have Mohammed Ayoub. Okay, next up we have Anastasia Bajanov. Gabriella Bender. Next up, we have Dana Batena, who received first in economics, had a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum, and a double plat as well. Okay, next up, we have Antonino Battaglia with a contribution to school sports also. Okay, next up is Selma Bedjic, who also received a bronze medallion. And apologies if I butchered your last name. We're practicing beforehand, but she'll let me know. Okay, next up we have Sophia Beiruti. Okay, we have Daria Borovic, who has a contribution to school sports and was also house captain of Elliot. Okay, Okay, next up is Ashana Bastani. Okay, next up is Estella Brain, who received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, got first in legal studies and first in history extension. Okay, we have Michaela Brand, who got first in food technology and also part of the student leadership team. Okay, we have Tane Brown, who was also a house captain and also contribution to school sports. Okay, next up, Nicholas Bunmi. Chanel Burgess, contribution to school sports, and also house captain of Thorpe. Okay, we have Claudia Corona, also of a contribution to school sports. Okay, we have Ellie Chawan. Okay, next up, we have Ashton Chan, also of a contribution of school sports. Okay, we have Aisha Chand. Okay, now we have Chloe Chang, who received bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, first in business studies, first in English Extension 1, first in legal studies, first in advanced mathematics, and first in modern history. I'll just take a little break from talking after that. Okay, and we have Crystal Chapman, who also has a contribution to school sports. Okay, we have Amani Chamand. Ethan Clayton. We have Jordan Coluccio with a contribution to school sports. Next up is Ryan Cooper, who came first in construction. Okay, the next person is Dean Corlett. Yeah. He had to be at TAFE today. It was his final day, so, you know, he chose TAFE. Next up is Lachlan Cox. He got a bronze medallion and also a contribution to school sports. Okay, next up is Elena Demjanovic, who got first in community and family studies. Okay, now we've got Princess Deb. Okay, now we've got Isabel Domes, who is house captain and also has a contribution to school sports. Okay, next up we have Akriti Dutt, who had a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, part of the student leadership, and was vice captain of 2021. Mohammed Ibrahim. Okay, we have Sami El Halou. Okay, next up we have Daniel Elphick, who has a contribution to school sports award. Okay, next up we have Angie El Said. Okay, next up we have Thomas Esho, who received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, first in Math Standard 2 and first in PDHPE. Alright, next up we have Ellie Etri. Layla Fada. And next up is Nima Fada. Okay, we have Hussein Afali. Okay, thanks. Got a shout out from the crowd. Thank you. Next up, we have Edson Fepalia'i. I think. Apologies, Edson, if I got the last name wrong, man. I practiced a lot, but. Okay, the next one, Will Fitzgerald, who was also house captain of Fraser and has a contribution to school sports. It was an easy one, I won't lie. Okay, next up we have Riley Franks, who received a bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, 100% attendance, house captain of Fraser, was part of the student leadership team and also had a contribution to school sports. Okay, we have Milanetta Fuyava. Grace Georges. Okay, next up we have Kyan Gibson, also of a contribution to school sport. All right, next up is Mariah Giles with a contribution of school sports and was also a house captain, a sports captain. Okay, we have Yusuf GoPro. All right, next one up is Keanu Gonzalez Martinez. Okay, now it's time for Aiden Guzev. Okay, we have Tatiana Grabez, who also received the bronze medallion and silver medallion. Okay, we have Ruby Grubner, who received the bronze medallion, silver medallion, gold medallion, platinum medallion, had a contribution to school sports, and was also first in visual arts this year. And a prolific selfie taker. Okay, next up is Cooper Gray with a contribution to school sports, who I believe is not here. I just got confirmation. Next up, we have just as good, Vin Ha. Scrambling. Okay, next up is Jamil Hamad, who also was first in ancient history. Okay, we have Alberto Hanna. Okay, we have Brooke Hannaford with a bronze and silver medallion. Okay, we've got Wahib Hassan. Okay, next one up, we have Montana Hatzikiriakos Melish. She'll also let me know if I got it right or wrong. Okay, next one up is Vincent He with a bronze, silver, and gold medallion. Okay, next one is Tiana Marie Hanare. Okay, next person is Paige Hodge, who got first in history extension, an achievement to school sports, and also a bronze medallion. Okay, next one up is Vina Hauscher with whose contribution to school sports and also part of the student leadership team.
Go, Vina!
Okay, next person is Syed Hussein with a bronze, silver, and gold medallion. Okay, we have Layla Ibrahim. Annabella Isaac. We have Daniela Isaac. Okay, next up we have Jonathan Jabor with a contribution to school sports, part of the student leadership team, yes, and was also a house captain of Fraser this year. Okay, we have George Demovich with a contribution to school sports.
I apologize.
And not surprisingly, the next person is Ivana Jemovich, with also a contribution to school sports. Okay, next person is Roman Juretic. And now we've got Sam John. Nikola Jovanovic with a contribution to school sports. Okay, we've got Shema Katea. Okay, next up we have Khaled Ketchban, who was also first in English studies. Okay, next one up, we have Vaibhav Khanna, who has a bronze, silver, gold, double plat medallions, first in chemistry, first in English advance, first in maths extension 1, first in maths extension 2, and a first in physics. And he still looks sad. Okay, and we have Saran Kiak.
I'm sorry.
I said it wrong.
Sorry.
The next person is Adrian Kumar, who had a bronze and silver medallions, got first in biology, first in English standard, and also first in information process and technology. Okay, next up we have Aidan Kumar. We'll be right back. Back on with our certificates. Next up, we have Natea Lacopo. Okay, next is Isabella Lazo, who got first in society and culture and also had 100% attendance. Okay, we have Nelissa Latelli Malazia. We have Christopher Litchi with a contribution of school sport. Okay, we have Simran Maharaj. And next we have Irfan Mahmood with a bronze medallion. Okay, we have Sasha Malia Bonello, who also finished with 100% attendance. Okay, we have Kiana McCarthy with a contribution of school sport, was part of the student leadership team, and was also house captain of Freeman. Okay, we have Daniela Medell. Okay, next we have George Milich with a contribution of school sport. Okay, next up we have Maliva Milutinovic. Okay, next up we have Tiana Miseri, who also got first in hospitality, food and beverage. Okay, next up we have Alana Mitwala Scala, who was house captain of Freeman, contribution of school sports, a bronze and silver medallion. Okay, next up is Sondos Mohammed Suleiman. Okay, we have Luke Moyera with a contribution of school sports. Okay, next up we have Zeeshan Munaf. Okay, and we have Crystal Murray. And then after that comes Michaela Murray. Obeda Mustafa, who is also part of our student leadership team. And we have Pranay Muthan, who is also part of our student leadership team. Next up, we have Stephanie Nettle, with bronze, silver, and gold medallion, contribution to school sports, and was also a house captain this year for Freeman. Okay, we have Tanisha Oberek Padilla. Next up, we have Carlos Olimpiada with a contribution to school sports. Okay, next up, we have Greg Neal, opener. Unfortunately, not able to be here today, but we do have Jamie Overell with a contribution to school sport. Here we have Shimaran Padaram with a bronze medallion and a contribution to school sport. Okay, next up, also not able to be here today, but William Peak. And we have Alyssa Pecora. Okay, next up is Yanni Periclius with a contribution of school sport. Okay, next up we have Lachlan Pimachan with a contribution to school sport. He's okay, everyone. All right, next up we have Angelina Poe with a first in business services, a bronze and silver medallion also. Okay, Georgia Pogson, part of the student leadership team, contribution to school sports, and house captain of Freeman. Okay, next up we have Jacoby Pohl with a contribution to school sport. Okay, we have Isba Romani. Okay, next up we have Shahir Raji with a bronze medallion and also a contribution to school sport. Okay, we have Sebastian Ribeiro, who was part of our student leadership team as well as being a captain, a contribution to school sports, and also finished first in SLR, or what is more accurately known, sport, leisure, and recreation. Okay, we have Brock Rewalt. And next up is Ashira Sami. Okay, and we have Cameron Sami. Okay, next is Ella Sherry, who got first in legal studies, first in investigating science, and also finished up with a bronze, silver, gold, and platinum medallion. Okay, we have Aya Sharan. Okay, and next up we have Sarah Bamunshoki. Okay, we have Zane Siddiqui. Okay, next up is Antonio Silva with a contribution to school sport. Okay, next is Joshua Smith with a contribution to school sports. Okay, we have Jennifer Star Maria. Cindy Sue with a bronze and silver medallion. Okay, we have Hawk and Sue, who finished first in music. Okay, next up we have Anastasia Subotic. And Dylan Satisna. Okay, next up is Mohammed Syed, who has a bronze, silver, gold medallion, part of the student leadership team, and was also one of our vice captains this year. Okay, next up is Lua Tanielu, who had a contribution to school sports and was also a house captain of Thorpe. Okay, next up is Gina Tarsizzi. Okay, we have Fasalafa Tavaga. James Tai. You have Jaden Tiu. Okay, we have Connor Trott. Okay, we have Daniel Tuutafava. Okay, next up we have Noah Tyler, who got first in ceramics. And after him we have Leila Yunul. Okay, we have Alex Violi. Anastasia Vukmirovic. Lachlan Walsh, who got a bronze and silver medallion. First in industrial technology medal, was part of our student leadership team, a contribution of school sports, and was also house captain of Thorpe.
What is that? Something in jeopardy.
That last happened when I was in year four, I think, Lachlan. So. Okay, next up we have Yopi Wang, who has a bronze, silver, gold, platinum, double platinum medallions. Was also first in entertainment course and had 100% attendance this year and also the years from 2016 right through. What? Be extra sad for you with us leaving. Okay, next up we have Justice Warner. Okay, next up we have Amy Wong. We have Simon Zarr, who had a contribution to school sports and 100% attendance for this year, which is still really good. Okay, next up we have Messi Yarko, who was part of our student leadership team, was a contributor to school sports, and was also house captain of Thorpe as well.
Yeah, it's good, good picks.
Okay, next up we have Mandy Zayden. Okay, we have Amy Zong, who has a bronze, silver, gold, platinum medallions, 100% attendance for this year, and was also part of our student leadership team. Okay, next up we have Vincent Zong, who is not here, but that's okay because we do have Ivan Zhu, who finished up with a bronze, silver, and gold medallion. Sorry, I went too fast then. Okay, and the last, but certainly not the least, we have Sarah Zumea.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell. We will now have the Year Advisors address.
I'm so sorry that I couldn't be there today. Some of you might already know that I'm no longer working at John Edmondson. I now work at Sydney Children's Hospital School, where I work quite closely with sick kids. So due to all of the COVID outbreaks, I need to be really, really careful and make sure that I don't go to anywhere where there's large gatherings. So for that reason, I cannot be there today, but I am so sorry. You know, I would have loved to have been there, and it really does sadden me that I couldn't be there to celebrate this milestone with you. However, I do have some words that I'd like to share with you. So, to the graduating class of 2021, it's been a wonderful journey and an honour to be your year advisor over the last 6 years. I've watched you grow and mature into the incredible young adults that you are now today. I remember your first day at John Edmondson High School. We had approximately 240 new faces. Some of you were quiet and unsure of what to expect of this high school journey that was ahead of you, but the vast majority of you were very eager to start high school. In fact, some would say that you were the most confident Year 7 group that we have ever had at John Edmondson High School. Normally takes a Year 7 group about 4 to 5 weeks to get settled into high school, but it took you guys, I'd say, 4 to 5 hours. The confidence, excitement, and eagerness that you displayed then has been evident throughout every single phase of your high school career, and this will be advantageous to you for the unknown chapters that lie in your life. Your senior years are meant to be the best years of school. I am so sorry that this was taken away from you. COVID-19 has truly shown us how unpredictable life can be, which is just a little taste of the real world. Like everything though, this is temporary. Many lessons have been learnt during this ordeal. Being in lockdown has emphasised the importance of family and friends. It has taught us to be present in the moment and appreciate the little things in life that we often take for granted. You may not realise it now, but the positive attitudes that you have shown, your resilience and your ability to adapt to the ever-changing situation are the keys to your future success. You have made teaching a fun, interesting, albeit a challenging career. You've kept me young by ensuring that I was up to date with all the latest trends, filters, music, and some of you, who I'm not going to mention, even offered regular fashion advice. Just as we all have done, in a few years, you too will look back on these perms and mullets and you will cringe. I want to give you some words of wisdom. Number one, drive safely. Your life and the lives of others are way too precious to toy around with. Number two, don't look to social media for a true depiction of reality, beauty, or happiness. focus on what makes you happy, live in the moment, and recognize your own beauty inside and out. Number three, do not smoke / vape. It is not cool. Trust me, I know cool. It is not good for you, and do I need to mention the thousands of pieces of scientific evidence to back this up? Number four, make the most of every single moment. Life is way too short. Time flies. There is no need to stress over the minute things and look for the best in every single situation. I know you're sick of me saying be positive, but honestly, if you look at the positive side of things, your life will be much more simple. Lastly, but I think this is the most important, always be kind and smile. This could be all that somebody needs to turn their day around. Being good to people is a wonderful legacy to leave behind. As you move into the next phase of your lives, I hope that you look back with fond memories, and without sounding too cliche, I hope that you follow your heart. Choose a career that you're passionate about. If you love what you do, you will do well in that role and you will be successful. Don't be afraid to change careers. Life's too short to be stuck in a career that you despise. Trust your gut and be confident in your choices. Thank you to each and every one of you. You have let down your guard and let me into your lives so that I could truly be there for you. I hope that I have done enough for you to feel that you were supported and truly cared for while you were at John Edmondson High. Year 12, 2021. I feel privileged to have been able to guide you over the years. You're ready for the world. I leave you with this quote. Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow. The important thing is to not stop questioning. Albert Einstein. Good luck. I wish you every success in the world. Take care of yourselves.
Sorry, I wasn't sure if I was going to get called up or not. All right. So after those words, there's nothing I could do to really compare, so I'll keep things short, as I guess all I can achieve. Truly, I've been thinking for weeks trying to work out what it is I was going to say to you guys. And if any of those that are not here today that are watching as well at home, this is for you as well. Truly, congratulations. Like, it's 13 years of your life, and at the age you guys are, the majority of your life has been school. You've been a school student. On Monday, you know where you're going to be. You wake up early, you put on that uniform, and you come into school. You have about 15 minutes until that's officially over. 13 years of your life will now be gone, which is, I guess, daunting, but also very exciting. You know, the opportunities that are afforded to the youth are certainly envious for the older people like myself. So for you guys, you know, I wish you the best of luck with everything you do. I hope it goes well. And like I'm saying, congratulations is not only to you, but everyone who supported you. Like, we know, you know, your parents, your family, your friends, they've all been a part of it. Even the students that used to be in your cohort that have now left, they were also a part of this journey and have helped all of you in different ways and have contributed to what is now being finalized. So yeah, I hope everything goes well. This will always be the high school you were at, so that can't be changed, and I hope you do have some fond memories from it. Thank you.
Thank you to both Ms. Karajanis and Mr. Campbell for your kind words. Now please sit back and enjoy your memories video from your time at John Edmondson High School.
favourite memory of Year 12?
I don't have any favourite memories, so they're quite unremarkable.
Favourite class?
Timber, followed closely by construction.
Do you have any favourite students?
No.
If you could describe Year 12 in one word, what would it be?
COVID.
Okay, what will you miss about them?
I will miss nothing.
Hey 12, all the best. Have a great future ahead of you, and wishing you all the very best and good luck. Miss Cleanthes, bye.
Year 12, I just want to say a really big congratulations on finally making it to the end of Year 12. It's been a really tumultuous two couple of years for you guys particularly, and you've all made it through with flying colours, so I want to thank you for all your hard work and your effort that you've put into all your classes, and I want to send a big congratulations and well done and all the best for your future.
Congratulations, Year 12. Well done. I miss you all so much. I hope you're doing well, and best of luck in the future.
Year 12. Awesome stuff. You guys are legends. Who goes through COVID? Who goes through all this and succeeds? It's excellent what you've done. We're going to miss you. You guys are champions. Shout out to my music class. You're the best.
So Year 12, 2020, 2021, they weren't the greatest years. But leave that all behind you, go out into the world, love what you see, be what you want to be, enjoy.
Hello Year 12, congratulations on finishing your school years, and it's going to be really a very nice journey starting your university and your other endeavours. Wishing you best of luck. It was a pleasure to have you in my classes. Take care.
Hi Year 12, I just want to congratulate you on finishing this crazy year. You all deserve to have such a good rest now. I'm hoping you all achieve everything that you want to, and that you get there, and that you just appreciate all the opportunities that are out there for you. Wishing you all the best. Bye.
Okay, Year 12, all the best with whatever you go on to in the future. A message from my Year 12 SLR class in particular. Stay classy and keep up the hard work. One of the hardest working classes I've ever had, and thoroughly enjoyed it.
Hey guys, best of luck with everything. I hope everything works out well for you. Try your best, and yeah, hope everything goes good. Hey, bye.
Alright, Year 12. It's been a long 2 years, but you've made it to the end, so big congratulations. All the best for the future, and to my CAFS girls, you guys rock.
Hi, Year 12. Good luck. You'll do really well with the future. I'm sure you'll do really well in whatever you like. Thank you.
Hello Year 12, so you finally made it. It's a COVID year, it's been tough, but you're a great bunch. I saw you all as little year sixes, and then I dogged you as your advisor. It hit me hard for a few days. And it's been a very special time knowing you guys. I've had some great classes, some great times, a good football team. Messi, you ruined it for us with your red card. We could have gone a long way with that team. But guys, you are a very special bunch, and I will look forward to seeing you in the real world. So yeah.
Congratulations Year 12 for making it through a very uneasy year. Good luck for you all in the future. Take care.
Hey Year 12, congratulations on finishing what has been a terrible 2 years for you. But you got through it, which just shows how resilient and wonderful you are. Special shout out to my amazing entertainment crew. Thank you for being so patient with me as I learnt about the course alongside you. And thank you for being amazing. Good luck in the future, and stay safe. Bye.
Morning Year 12. Congratulations on finally finishing school. I know this has been the longest Year 12 basically ever, but you've finally done it. You are free. Enjoy the rest of your lives, and best of luck for the future.
Hi Year 12. Just wanted to wish you all the best for your lives ahead. You've been a very memorable group, particularly my SLR class, one of the great groups of all time.
I just want to congratulate you on surviving a horrendous year in so many respects. Well done. You are amazingly resilient, and you have dedicated yourselves in the harshest of climates, so congratulations on finishing Year 12.
Favourite memory of Year 12?
Favourite memory of Year 12, not in
in particular, but it was very, very satisfying teaching them during lockdown period, because they all were very, very receptive and supportive of me, what I was teaching.
Your favorite class?
My favorite class is my year 12 biology class.
Okay. Your favorite student?
Favorite student? All of them are favorite. They're all good, yeah.
Army Hardies, year 12. It's been a really topsy-turvy, up-and-down year. But congratulations, honestly. You've survived and got through it.
Hi, year 12. Good luck with, you know, whatever you choose to do from Friday onwards. Behave, be good, and hopefully you are going to be contributing citizens and, you know, stay in the right path.
All right, hi, year 12. Congratulations on graduating.
Hi, year 12. You guys are like one of the last generations that remembers me being a fat guy, even though I'm headed back in that direction now. So I'm actually kind of glad you guys are leaving, because then no one will remember I was ever fat. I'm extremely proud of you guys because you've dealt with something really difficult and you've finished year 12.
Hello, year 12. I'm super proud of what you guys have achieved this year, particularly with what COVID has thrown around this year and last year. You're a credit to yourself and to your families. I'm super proud of how you've been exemplary in rising to the challenges that this year presented. I wish you all the best for your future endeavors, whatever life may bring to you. All the best, we will miss you.
Hey, year 12, it's been a hell of a year, but we certainly wish you all the best for the future. We know you can do great things, but congratulations for getting through to the end of the year, and all the best.
Goodbye, year 12!
Shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. Can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me.
wrong one.
Please step aside. Seven fees coming through.
Ignore. Is it? Is it? Is it? That's why we're going home.
After that, we're gonna rap again, cause I know we're gonna win.
I would now like to call upon our 2021 captains, Aisha Ali and Sebastian Ribeiro, to join us on stage for the final captain's address. It's been a tough 2 years for us. Our class of 2021 has actually been through the toughest 2 years that any senior years have ever experienced, and somehow we were able to overcome it. That just shows how resilient and dedicated we are to our school lives, especially since this was our last few moments of high school. Honestly speaking, it was definitely not the greatest and was very difficult for each and every one of us.
We have persevered through one heck of a senior career, and I'd just like to say congratulations on everyone for getting through. I know it's been tough on everyone, but my advice is to stay calm because good things come to those who wait, and just remember that life is a funny way of making things work out in the end.
On behalf of both Seb and I, we would like to say a big thank you to all the teachers that tried their hardest to give us the closest thing to a normal year given the current circumstances. Thank you to Mrs. Zulik and Mr. Dwyer for their immense support and patience with all the fundraisers and events, and the staff and students for trying their best and staying consistent throughout the year. Finally, I would like to thank all my friends for keeping things positive and always reminding me that school's about to finish, because we were all very keen for a break. Thank you, class of 2021, and good luck on your future endeavors.
I'd like to add on to the thank you for the friends by actually specifically mentioning the boys for giving everyone here the memorable time, the memorable high school career that I know we've all had. And the term send it, in its term means send it, but with everything in life you should send it, because if you don't, you're going to regret the chances you never take. And the other boys.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you all for your attendance today. This brings us to the end of our ceremony. Could I ask all parents to remain seated while graduated class of 2021 leave the hall? Thank you.
My father said, you can do anything you want with your life. You just have to be willing to work hard to get it. That's when I decided, when I die, I want to be remembered for the life I lived.
He said one day you'll leave this world behind. So live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. To those shining stars, he said, go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day, my father, he told me, son, don't let it. can't put out. Carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just